Treaties have I made, O Theophilus, of all that Jesus began both to do and teach until the day in which he was taken up. After that, he through the Holy Ghost had given commandments unto the apostles whom he had chosen, to whom also he showed himself alive after his passion by many infallible proofs, being seen of them 40 days and speaking of the things pertaining to the kingdom of God.
The Bible says in Acts chapter 1, Luke writes, and he's telling a scripted story from the accounts that he had gotten from those that were there and those that were eyewitnesses. He records the acts of the apostles, and he writes them just as it was told to him. Some kind of way he's talking and telling this story to a man named Theophilus. According to theologian, Theophilus was like a noble Roman servant and a person of high authority that was inquisitive about this man named Jesus. Luke begins to write this treatise unto him and tell him about the things that Jesus done, things that he had taught. He begins to tell him that I'm telling you that these were his acts until the day in which he was taken up by the Holy Ghost. These were the things that happened. He showed himself alive after his resurrection. 40 days he spent with his disciples. things concerning the kingdom of God.
Yes.
Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
The Bible says that Luke says that he showed himself after his passion, after his suffering, with many infallible proofs. Said, I have witnessed that they seen him, that they talked with him. And now, here we are, verse number 4.
And being assembled together with them, commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father, which saith he, ye have heard of me.
He said, before he left, he said he spent time with the disciples. He had assembled them together in a room, and he talked with them, and he commanded that they would go into Jerusalem and not leave Jerusalem until the promise came. Somebody shout glory. Hallelujah. Between the 40th day, Elisites, and the 50th day, something happened. From the 40th day to the 50th day, something remarkable happened. Oh, glory be to God. The Bible says he charged them, he commanded them that they should not depart from Jerusalem, but wait for the promise of the Father. So this promise that we're talking about, saints of God, was not only just talked about here in the New Testament, but it was the promise of the Father. Yes. It was that God had promised was going to come from the beginning of time. This is the promise. Yes, the blood being shed.
Yes,
suffering the death of the cross. Rising on the third day. Ascending into heaven. Then he sends the comforter. This is the promise. And he said, for those that would listen to me and wait for the promise. Somebody shout glory. Said it's coming. It's a special gift that is for all the people of God. Since God, the Holy Ghost is for everybody. Somebody shout glory. The Holy Ghost is for all walks of life. And I get excited when I talk about it, because this is what Jesus died for. This is what he rose. This is what he ascended into heaven to send us back some power. Mark talks about the power and what it would do once you get the power. Somebody shout glory. Read verse 5 for me, Elder Johnson.
For John truly baptized with water.
He said, listen, I know you all are familiar with John's baptism, and John's baptism was just preparing a way for me. He was telling everybody to repent, get them ready, because the kingdom is at hand. So John's message was preparing folks for Jesus. John's message was preparing folks that Jesus is coming. Somebody shout, look, our message, every last one of us here, our message is tell the world, guess what? Jesus is coming back again, and you need to be saved, and you need to be sanctified, and you need to be Holy Ghost filled. Every last one of us should have a message, but it's seemingly everybody's got a different message. Somebody shout glory. In the message that I'm telling you today, healing, deliverance, prosperity, all of that is in the message of Jesus. In the power of the Spirit. Everything that we need is in the message of Jesus. Somebody shout glory. When you get Jesus, you get it all. When you get the Spirit, you get it all. You get the blessing. He said, John truly baptized with water. Oh, glory to God. But ye shall be baptized with the Holy Ghost not many days hence. Now, calling the Holy Spirit, the Holy Ghost, the presence of God is all the same. The Holy Ghost is going to come not many days after you get to Jerusalem and after you stay there. Matter of fact, according to my recollection and my counting, 40 days he spent with his disciples. He ascended, Lord have mercy, from the Mount of Olives. He ascended up to heaven. And they were there, and the Bible said that the men were gazing at while Jesus left the earth and he goes up into heaven. Somebody said there was an angel there and telling them, said, look, look at you men. There were two men that stood by in white apparel. And he said unto them, ye men of Galilee, said, why are you staying here gazing up into the heaven? Said, the same Jesus, which is taken up from you into heaven, he shall so like manner also have you seen him go. He shall so come back in the same manner that he ascends into heaven. He's coming back. Somebody tap somebody, tell them, say, Jesus is coming back. Somebody shout yes. But the writer says, here he said, listen, said, you're going to receive the Holy Ghost. The baptism of the Holy Ghost is coming. Somebody shout glory. And it's going to come with power. Somebody say power. And I heard Luke say, it is not for you to know the times of the season which the Father had put in his own power. But ye going to receive, verse number 8, the power after the Holy Ghost is come upon you. And ye shall be witnesses of me both in Jerusalem and in all Judea. I want to talk to the saints for a little while to tell you and ask you a question. Are you talking about it? Are you saying something about it? Are you keeping quiet? Somebody ought to know that you know Jesus. Somebody ought to know that you are spirit-filled because you're supposed to be his witness. Say yes, somebody. And if it filled you, you shouldn't be ashamed of it. But you ought to be telling the world that I got good news to tell you about the Lord. And I'm so glad that I'm saved. I'm so glad I'm filled with the power of the Holy Ghost. And when you get this power, it's some Lord have mercy. Some things going to happen in your life. The devil won't be able to destroy you. If you believe in his name, you got power to tell the devil, you got to go from my home. You're going to get off my children. I command you, devil, to let my children out. Let them alone. You can cast out the devils in the name of Jesus. Say yeah. Ask yourself, are you a believer? Say yeah. Are you a believer? Say yeah. In my name, in my name, I got power to tell the devil, you're not going to destroy my son no more. You're not going to destroy my daughter no more. Because the Holy Ghost that's within me, by the power and the authority, I cast you out. Go! Go! Be healed! Be delivered! The Bible says, every believer with the Holy Ghost, you're going to speak with a new tongue. Somebody shout glory. And the Spirit of God give us utterance. Somebody say yeah. There will be a happy time in your life. And if you get a hold of a serpent, an old dragon, you're not aware of it, be careful. God says, give you divine protection. The serpent will not bite you, will not destroy you. You'll be like Paul. Say yeah. You'll be like Paul. You'll be able to shake him off. You'll be able to shake that serpent. Matter of fact, some of y'all have some devils holding on to you. Shake it off. Shake it off. And devil, get off of me. You got to understand, you need the Holy Ghost. The Holy Ghost got so much power.
is food. Everybody is cooking. Y'all hear me? And it's good practice not to eat or drink from everybody. Matter of fact, it's not good to go somewhere, put your drink down, and come back and drink it again. Those of you that go to clubs, I shouldn't be none of y'all here, but if you do, if that's what you do, you better be careful laying your drink down and you go somewhere and you don't know what folk drop in it. But the Holy Ghost says, if I'm in a situation where I don't know, and if I drink, oh Lord have mercy, then the pause, it shall not harm me. Somebody shout glory. You got the Holy Ghost. God will protect you. Some of you are living and folk don't understand how you're living. When you got the Holy Ghost, witchcraft and sorcery can't come through the blood, because there's power in the Holy Ghost. I'm getting ready to go here. But the promise that I'm talking about is the promise of the Spirit and the power of God. And folk are going to church year after year, day after day, and they're just putting on clothes, going and having a good time, but they don't have relationship. And what the Spirit of God does, the Holy Ghost brings us back into relationship with God. What the rules and the regulations of the old law could not do, Jesus being the fulfillment of the law in the flesh, died the death of the cross, shed his blood for the ultimate sacrifice, rose on the third day, sitting in the heaven, sitting upon the right hand of God the Father Almighty, sends back the comforter, tells the apostles, I'm equipping you with what you need to further the kingdom work on earth while I'm gone. Though I'm gone, my spirit is with you, and I'm going to dwell in you, and I'm going to be with you even till the end of the world. Here comes the Holy Ghost. They gather at Jerusalem. Say yes, somebody. The Bible says they returned at Jerusalem from the mount called Olivet, which is from Jerusalem, a Sabbath day's journey. Say yes, somebody. 12-hour journey to get from the Mount of Olivet to Jerusalem. Say yes. The Bible says when they come to Jerusalem, they were coming in. They went up, y'all, in a place called an upper room. And there in the upper room, there was Peter, James, and John, Andrew, and Philip. Thomas and Bartholomew, Alphaeus, James the son of Alphaeus, Simon the Zealot, say yes, somebody, there was there, also women was with them. The Bible said, Mary, oh Mary, the mother of Jesus, and with his brother, Mary, and Jesus' brother, was there in the upper room. If you read scripture, this is the last event where you ever hear of Mary right here in the book of Acts, chapter number 1. Say yes, somebody. And I love Mary, but oh Mary, it is Jesus that is the important one. Say yeah. Thank God for Mary. But Mary needed the Holy Ghost. Do y'all hear me? That's why if Mary needed the Holy Ghost, we need the Holy Ghost. If Mary needed it, I need it. If Mary needed it, you need it. Holy Ghost, the power that worketh on the inside.
this, that makes me move, that makes me shout. What is this that makes me turn all about? What is this? Come on, come on. They were in the upper room. They were in the upper room. Y'all stop coming to church and just sitting in church. Spirit goes high, say, fill me, Lord, fill me up, let me overflow, fill me up, give me the Holy Ghost.